so we are going to break down the president's State of the Union address some more. Joining me now are two veteran political consultants on the Democratic side. We have Steve Maviglio. Republican side, we have Tim Rosales. Gentlemen, thank you for being with us tonight. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Thanks.
Okay, so initial thoughts, since it's a Republican president, we're going to start with the Republican on the desk. Tim Rosales, what did you think of the president's speech tonight?
Well, I thought it was a good speech. I think he accomplished what he needed to accomplish. I think he spoke to the states that are going to decide this election. And, people who were for the president before this speech, I think they liked what he had to say. Mm-hmm. You saw, for a majority of the speech, grimaces and grouses from Nancy Pelosi and others, and I don't think he changed any minds there. But I do think he spoke to an important American constituency in several of these swing states, and that is going to be critical, particularly coming on the heels of a disastrous Iowa caucus with the Democrats yesterday. I think these were that built upon itself, two bad days for the Democrats and a good day for Trump.
All right, Steve, what do you think?
I think a lot of Democrats wanted to put him on that rocket to Mars that he was talking about.
Okay.
Because he threw out a lot of red meat, the kind of divisiveness that he's shown throughout his presidency. You'd think this would be the year he tried to bring people together heading to an election, but he talked about those red button, hot button issues of abortion, the border wall, immigration, and run against California, which, he's not going to win our state, but he's trying to play that up throughout the nation.
Yeah, the economy really taking a center stage on this. I remember past State of the Union addresses, it started with immigration. He unveiled the four pillars of his policy, but this was really at the top, very driven on the economy, which is most likely going to be his message as he progresses in this presidential race, right?
Absolutely. I think he's going to talk about what he's done on the economy. There's going to be arguments about that. But certainly that's something that he's put front and center. He's going to talk about health care, and he is going to talk about issues like immigration and issues that may not necessarily be popular in California, but let's not kid ourselves. He's not campaigning for California. He's campaigning against California to the rest of the nation. And the rest of the nation kind of looks at California and says, hey, what are those guys doing over there most of the time? And we've had this mass exodus of people leaving the state of California. And to some degree, he's not wrong for doing that. And I think it's a smart strategic move.
What did you think about, you couldn't help but see what Speaker Pelosi was thinking when the president was saying a few things. She was kind of wearing her emotions on her face a couple of times.
Yeah, she's not good about hiding that issue.
Right.
No, but she was rolling her eyes, and I think the PolitiFact and the other nonpartisan people that fact-check the president, the meter is going off the hook because his pants are on fire. He's a perpetual liar about things. And what's fascinating for me, he's running against California, yet it's the California economy that's driving the rest of the nation's economy. So you can't take a shot at us for all these social policies while not acknowledging that we're the driving force behind the economic success of this country right now.
So he mentioned progressive California. Mm-hmm. Do you think that is kind of a swipe at Bernie Sanders, who is kind of seen as lead? I mean, we don't have the full results of Iowa yet, but it's Bernie Sanders and Mayor Pete, and Bernie Sanders is seen as someone that's going to stay at the top of the pack, as polls say right now.
Well, if I'm the president, and I think that it's a mistake for Republicans to take Bernie Sanders lightly. Mm-hmm. I think that he has got an energy. I think his base and his constituency is motivated, and I do not think that he is a pushover. So if any Republican out there is saying, hey, let's root for Bernie Sanders. I mean, I remember back in 1998, when Dan Lundgren was running for governor, the conventional wisdom was, oh, let's get Gray Davis. He's going to be the weakest of the three candidates on the Democratic side. Lo and behold, Gray Davis comes out and wins by 20 points. Be careful what you wish for. I do not think Bernie Sanders is a pushover. I think he is somebody that the president should be, take a serious look at. And, again, he did a good job tonight, but don't count any of these Democrats out.
I thought it was interesting, too. I want to talk about the demographics that he addressed in the speech, and also pointing to the ad that the president had during the Super Bowl talking about criminal justice reform. And then he went through each demographic from African-American to veterans unemployment. Is that his way, do you think, of trying to reach out and kind of maybe broaden past his base a little bit?
Yeah, I think so. He needs at least 10, 15% of the African-American vote in this country to make this a contested election, because at the end of the day, it's going to matter four or five states. You know, we can talk about how great we are in California, but he's not talking to us. He's not talking to New York. He's talking to those states he needs to win. And Democrats have to figure out how to talk about the economy in those states, which they're having a little trouble doing. Bernie Sanders has his way of doing it, talking about income inequality. The rest of Democrats are still fumbling a little bit there. Healthcare is going to be a big issue for Democrats. You know, he lied again about pre-existing conditions and the Affordable Care Act. But
there were some audible responses
to
that.
Well, yeah, and rightly so. But, you know, we'll have to see how that all plays out.
I'm just kind of wondering how the president is going to tout this week, because you have what happened, the first voting contest in Iowa, the president's speech tonight, and then a likely acquittal for impeachment tomorrow. I mean, he's going to say, I won the week, right?
Who knows what the president's going to say from minute to minute,
That's
day
very
to day.
True. He shouldn't try to put words in his mouth.
You know, right there, you know, neither one of us can predict that, and I don't think, you know, his staff can necessarily predict that. But certainly, I think logically, that's what he would have to do. We've got an impeachment vote and things coming up here later this week. So, you know, anything can happen. But right now, I think he is in a pretty good position. I think the Democrats stepped on themselves yesterday in Iowa, didn't do themselves any favors, you know, there. So kind of, you know, an unforced error, if you will. So we'll see what happens. But again, we are millions of miles away. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're in these primaries, but we're millions of miles away from November, and the world can change. Mike Bloomberg was just here, you know, in California yesterday campaigning. Mm-hmm. I think he was, you know, you could say he was the winner of the Iowa caucus. I don't know what you say, Steve.
Yeah, quite possible. But, you know, it's interesting how he was thumbing his nose at the Democrats. I mean, putting the Medal of Honor on Rush Limbaugh, who's like hated among Democrats, that is just like pushing her right in there.
Very unusual to see that presentation happened during the State of the Union, right?
Right.
No matter what side you're
on. It was very
on.
Political, but the moment he walked in and the Republicans were chanting four more years, I've never, ever seen such a highly charged political atmosphere in the Congress like that. I mean, you see it during legislative debates, but chanting an election theme, I mean, that's way out of bounds.
Yeah, it was definitely unique. They're breaking all the rules. Pelosi, you know, ripping up the speech at the end, the handshake snub. You've got...
We're in unknown territory right now.
Completely unknown territory. And for political observers, I mean, it's just, you know, you sit back and it was, it's as interesting as a Super Bowl. So,
Steve Maviglio, Tim Rosales, guys, we could probably spend another hour breaking this down.
Absolutely,
Stay tuned for that. All right. We appreciate your time. Thanks so much.